Hello friends, myself Chirag. Today I am going to discuss with you time served common bus multiprocessor system, topic of computer organization and architecture. There are four different schemes in interconnection structure of multiprocessor system. First one, time served common bus. Second one, multiport memory. Third one, crossbar switch. Fourth one, multi-stage switching network. Today we will discuss time served common bus. A common bus multiprocessor system consists of a number of processors connected through a common path to a memory unit as shown in figure. Now see the diagram. This is the memory unit. There are different five processors connected to the memory unit with a single path, or we can say single bus. Only one processor can communicate with the memory or another processor at any given time. It means CPU1 access the bus at that time. Remaining CPU is in waiting mode for the availability of bus. Transfer operations are conducted by the processor that is in control of the bus at the time. As per our example, CPU1 access the bus. It means a data transfer process, or we can say read-write operation inside the memory unit by CPU1 only. The remaining processors will in waiting mode. Any other processor wants to transfer, first check the availability of the bus. If bus is not available, it is in idle mode. When bus is available, processor address the destination unit to initiate the transfer. So a command is issued to inform the destination unit what operation is to be performed. When destination unit receive this command from the sender, at that time receiving unit recognize its address in the bus and respond to the control signal from the sender, after which the transfer is initiated. When source get the response from the receiver, at that time transfer process is going on. The system may exhibit transfer conflicts since one common bus is shared by all processors. These conflicts must be resolved by incorporating a bus controller that establishes priorities among the requesting units. So this is the limitation for a single bus processor, a time shared common bus. A single common bus system is restricted to one transfer at a time. So at a time, only one CPU or one processor can transfer the data with memory unit. This means that when one processor is communicating with the memory, rest of the processor will busy with their internal operation or must be idle waiting for the bus. As a consequence, the total overall transfer rate within the system is limited due to single path communication. This is the limitation of the single bus system. Performance of the system can increase if two or more independent buses to permit simultaneous bus transfer. So we can increase the number of buses, independent buses for the processor, so performance of the system will be increased. However, this increases the system cost and complexity, both are increases. A more economical implementation of a dual bus structure is shown in figure. So this is the independent buses is given to the all modules. However, we have a number of local buses, each connected to its own local memory and to one or more processor. Each local bus may be connected to a CPU and IOP or any combination of processors. So this is the local bus, this is another local bus, this is third local bus. So all local bus connected with the CPU, IOP, local memory and also connected with the system bus controller. A system bus controller links each local bus to a common system bus. So you can see over here in this figure, this is the local bus, a local bus connected to the system bus via system bus controller only. The IO devices connected to the local IOP as well as the local memory are available to the local processor. It means IO bus IO devices connected to this IOP or this local memory, or some of the input output devices connected to this IOP and this local memory. The common shared memory connected to the common system bus is shared by all processors. Now you can see this. This is the common shared memory. It is connected with only system bus. If an IOP can connect it directly to the system bus, the IO device attached to it may be made available to all processors. So as per the above statement, we can say the IOP is directly connected with the system bus. So we can say that all IOP, it means all input output devices available for the all processor modules. Only one processor can communicate with the shared memory through the system bus. So we can say this processor will access shared memory at that time. Remaining CPUs or remaining IOPs will in waiting mode. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and comment. Subscribe my channel on YouTube. Press bell icon to get new video notification. Thank you.